If Zuma want to form a party, it is fine. He can call it Msholozi. He can call it Zuma. He can call it whatever he wants to call it. But we will never leave him to run away with MK.
Here is something that I love about MK. They are quick to take decisions. So I've been speculating, and I spoke to a lot of people about the Secretary General. So this is the equivalent of Fikile Mbalula. So I've been speculating, asking people, is he fired? Is he not fired? Is he fired because he does not get along with Zambudla? And so a lot of back and forth people do not know, but a credit to other MK people, they've issued I don't know, it's not a statement. So someone spoke as to why Zwane was fired, because initially it was because of that, and the indication is that because he failed. And I just want to sum it up, you will listen to him himself, because he failed, and that failure resulted in enormous repercussions. He failed to organize the president's office, that is JZ, into a position, into an opportunity to run KwaZulu-Natal. So a case in point is he mismanaged the office of the president and in a way could not secure a negotiation position with IFP, and thus the result, and that's the far-reaching consequences. They lost KwaZulu-Natal. If you think of that is consequence management. This is like the best, if it's true, of course, like the best way of us seeing that if someone messes up, there is accountability. And if that is true, of course, there was a firing and misfiring, resignation and not resignation, but being that as it may, I'm just happy if that is what has happened. And I think even Zwane would not mind if this he's fired, and if that is what he actually did. I want you to tell you, because this will of course be rumors, but you listen to the guy himself. So if this is true, just think of Fikile Mbalula. I have said many times on this podcast that Fikile Mbalula fails, and Fikile Mbalula's own admission as the engine of the ANC. The secretariat is the engine of an organization. They could not, when they did their political intelligence, they could not in time fight MK when it was gazetted, fight MK when it was, the logos were out, fight, blah, blah, blah. So you'd remember in the previous court cases, it was the fact that MK was way too in. MK was already a confirmed political party and electoral court, blah, 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 because things were done late. And I want to say, Fikile Mbalula has done more damage to the ANC than what Zwane has done. But Zwane has been left out. So if that would have been a signal, if that would have been, so is MK, because I've spoken a lot about democracy, the problem with democracy. So let's say it's JZ, I'm assuming, of course, let's say it was JZ's decision to say, I'm letting him go because he failed spectacularly. He could be good in other things, but on this one he failed, and they let him go. I understand. So you would remember at EFF, before Marshal Dlamini came, that office was run by Godrej Kadi, and he was studying law, and he's not as energetic. He's very close with Julius Malema, he's very close with the cadres, the same way the chairperson was close, Comrade Tumpof, with everyone. But for organizational interest, they had to bring someone in. Because if you if your plate is full, and this is what we had initially when Zwane left, if the plate is full, then there's no way they're gonna assist you if the plate is full. So they had to let him go. But please tell us what you think about this.
Oh, sebe azonta baga kwanza kuto uzuano kusheluene. Sebe angbache kuto kusheluene kuzuano ngomba bazu kuto kusheluene bazu kupigi isa ina tena water maaki signature fake fake letter. Abanda basi kujina banga zungusara ringe kumla. If you keep them updated, ba pesi ba yasnini. Shumde tu anzama ni kwenye tlatenga kuu. Kuto kusheluene uzuano. Na anzo kutofanya ngipendule manyo. Icala likaZwane ngesikhathi kuhlela ama-negotiations, uZwane uyena umuntu oyinjiniya eqembu. uZwane uyena umuntu obetshela umongameli uNxamalala ukuthi aye kumuphi umhlangano. uZwane wadukisa uNxamalala wamshonisa emhlanganweni orong. Umhlangano orong wawuphi na? Umhlangano wawuseRichards Bay. Wayakhona uZwane Richards Bay emhlanganweni, wayisa uNxamalala emhlanganweni. I-IFP yalinda 4 hours. So ke into eyenzekile manje i-MK isithe Zwane wena umuntu responsible ukuthi iqembu lingakwazi ukuthi liholi province, ngoba walindisa umkhuleko ohlanga nomongameli wa-IFP nethemu labaxoxa lama negotiations i-IFP ufowaze hotela. Yasithi MK ke Zwane wena uzophenda siyaxolisa ku-IFP, siyasho ukuthi wena obo responsible ukuthi uholele iqembu eyibini, ngakho ke sikhomba indlela mangethe. Sixoshela ukuthi wali ngabe iqembu liphethe iprovince, ngoba i-IFP yeza ingxoxweni ze-MK, MK yabenzela phansi. So i-IFP ayinalo icala, ne-MK sithi ayinalo icala. Ngoba i-GNU izowa nje khona kuzokwenzeka abafana lindelani, njengoba nginikeza nje ngempukane zehlazi ukuthi i-GNU iyaqhaqhazela, i-GNU iyanyakaza, i-IFP ibuyele ekhaya njengamanje. uZwane uyena owalidela iqembu eyibini ukuthi aholele angayisi umongameli emithingini, ahambise umongameli emhlanganweni orong, angabambisi uNxamalala la ilinde khona. Siyabonga
ukuthi silapha namhlanje to reclaim what is rightfully ours.
We have no issue with Mr. Zuma. He can call the party any other name as long as it's not called Umkhonto weSizwe, because that is our name. It is a norm to get breakaway parties. It started with the PAC in the 60s and the Group of Eight, and then followed by COPE in the New Dispensation.
Meanwhile, former President Jacob Zuma also addressed a group of MK party supporters outside the Durban High Court. Zuma says the ANC brought a nun case before the court.
Silwini baye baxakeka kuleli bazokwenza njani ngoba alikho hayi ukuthi kushintsha ma kushintsha inkantola kashintshi bebengazi ukuthi bazothini ngishabela ungibengingiza bekhuluma isingisi sabangabaqoba ukuthi bathini ngoba kukho lutho into ebiyenzekile ukuthi laba bakagogo abayijwayele lento abayijwayele ngoba bacabanga ukuthi yonke into bayiwina nje noma berobha bayawina nje noma bekhipha imali bayawina nje hayi ke kunomehluko manje thina siwumkhonto weSizwe uyayizwa leyo nto khona abanye okuthiwa amaqembu kuthiwe into enanyancanyana amaganyana angasho lutho nje namagama angaziwa abanye bethu umkhonto siwazi sonke masithanda sithi kili rumo kili rumo lasishaba
and Zuma chose this moment knowing very well that in the body politic of KZN there is a void. Umntwana kaphinda gene passed away and then the NFP is dead. and then it's the IFP and the ANC, and the king is no more. So there's nobody in the presidency of national government who is looked upon by the constituency base of KZN as somebody they look up to at the present moment. We suffered the blows already when we did our assessment because Shembe Church spoke against us, and we lost heavily many municipalities in KZN. This was the second one. And then the JZ factor was a problem. The July riots and the Zuma arrest was a factor in relation to those elections. As much as there were elections that were declared and ran within a short space of time, the Zuma factor has always been with us. And when Zuma now decided to take our paraphernalia and our trademark and form the party and say, I'm a double ANC member, like a double agent, don't ask me. I'm Zuma, I'm rescuing the ANC. It further polarized.